Hello and welcome to the Inside Take, our UU Holton Weekly Service online edition, coming to you from a stone room in the basement of a Unitarian church. The Inside Take is an inquisitive look into the interior life and the creative outer expressions it takes in everyday life as we go about living in this extraordinary world. Today on the Inside Take, we look at the theme of hope in the Star Wars movies and expanded universe created by George Lucas. The Star Wars audience spans all age groups and nationalities. It captures a human story and the human struggle of good versus evil and hope versus despair. These memorable characters and their heroic actions help to ignite hope when we are having a hard time doing so. Today, we head to a galaxy far, far away. Thank you for joining us. This is the Inside Take. The chalice lighting today comes from the UUA worship app. The chalice lit among us is a beacon of hope in a world in crisis, a beacon of possibility made manifest in community, a beacon of warmth through interactions, a beacon of light illuminating our shared wisdom, a beacon of connection by our being together. We light this chalice this morning. For our moment of centering silence, I have a short reading from The Dharma of Star Wars, written by Matthew Bordelon. Always in motion, the future is. It is unborn, unsubstantial. It's merely an image, like a hologram of a living being. We can no more touch and feel the future than we can touch and feel a hologram. The future, then, is unreal because it is not present. Only the present is real. Only this moment is alive. So let us stop and notice the right here and now. Only this moment is alive. Relax, breathe, and listen to the sound of a chime. In keeping with the Star Wars theme today, I am once again reading from The Dharma of Star Wars by Matthew Bordelon. Ignorance is the path to the dark side. One who is practicing the way must always keep the mind open. Such a one must observe, listen, and learn. Truth is found in the most unlikely of places. Before you act, you must reflect. Reflect unwisely and troubles follow as surely as a droid follows the mandates of its programming. Reflect wisely and troubles are like a shadow in the void of space, unseen and unfelt. Hatred cannot defeat hatred. If hatred is directed toward you, combat it with kindness. That is the only way to defeat hatred. Love conquers everything. This morning, let us go ahead and light our candles. At the time of this recording, Thursday morning, after weeks of increasing tension, Russia has just invaded Ukraine and there is open conflict. I'm not sure what the conditions will be when you are viewing this broadcast, but this open violation of international law is a low point for international relations, the United Nations, and civil cooperation. We pray for the safety of those caught in the middle of this violent outbreak, and we hope for a quick ceasefire. Our hearts are heavy on this day. May peace find its way back from violence and conflict. We light this candle. This is the last Sunday in February, so we light a candle of making it through another cold and stormy month, and now it's on to March. This candle is also for Mardi Gras on Tuesday, March 1st, and then Ash Wednesday as the Christian season of Lent begins. We continue to light a crisis candle for the continuing coronavirus pandemic. While numbers continue to improve, there is a new Omicron variant, BA2, which has recently entered the United States. It's still too early to tell much about the new variant, but it looks like this isn't over yet. So we're hanging in there. And we light this silent candle today for those unspoken prayers, concerns, and anxieties that we have this morning, not knowing what may be coming next on so many fronts in our life and in our world. So let's just take and create space for a few moments to reflect and to hold these concerns in a thoughtful manner as we direct our prayers and our best towards those that we love, that we care for, and the concerns that we carry on this day. For those concerns and those names mentioned this morning, we hold them in the light of love and compassion. May our group energy benefit all beings far and wide, and may our own minds be restored and renewed to a positive and healing state. Blessed are we all on this day. Amen, and blessed be. To set the tone for our Star Wars feature content today, we have a slideshow of images from the Star Wars series, which began in 1977 with the release of A New Hope, and the Star Wars franchise, with its numerous spin-offs, continues to this day. The song we selected for today is from the original Star Wars soundtrack with John Williams and the London Symphony Orchestra. This is from the famous cantina scene in Mos Eisley. Cantina Band. Cantina Band. So today, for part 8 of our series on hope, we are traveling to a cinematic universe a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Star Wars, created by George Lucas over 40 years ago now, and we are looking at the theme of hope that runs throughout the series of films. In case you're wondering where the title of today's talk came from, A New Hope Awakens, I borrowed it from a talk I gave at the Unitarian Society of Holton back in 2015, the year that the Star Wars sequel trilogy began, Star Wars 7, 8, and 9. Since there were similar story arcs and parallel thematic construction in the original Star Wars, Star Wars 4, A New Hope, and Star Wars 7, The Force Awakens, you can see that I combined the two movie titles into one, A New Hope Awakens. So there you have the backstory on that. I also brought in a couple of props for today's talk, just for the fun of it. I brought in my Anakin Skywalker lightsaber, which is here, sitting on the desk. And I also brought the upgraded version of the lightsaber, which lights up, and it has four studio version sound effects to the lightsaber. It also works great as a flashlight in the dark. And here is a Star Wars book, The Return of the Jedi by Tom Engelberger, which was given to me just this past Christmas as a present. And I brought in one of my favorite Star Wars action figures, R2-D2, which I always carry with me in my laptop computer case. So he's going to sit right here on the desk during today's talk. Droids appear everywhere in the Star Wars universe, and two of the most famous are C-3PO, a protocol droid fluent in more than 7 million forms of communication, and R2-D2, an astromech droid known for heroic resourcefulness and his adorable blips and beeps. These two droids open the original Star Wars movie crossing the desert on Tatooine in search of Obi-Wan Kenobi, an old Jedi master who's gone into hiding. C-3PO is already complaining, saying, "We seem to be made to suffer. It's our lot in life. Will it ever end?" R2-D2 is secretly carrying a message from Princess Leia, which contains plans to the Death Star, a new super weapon of the Empire. After a harrowing adventure, the two droids end up being sold to Luke Skywalker's uncle, And as Luke is cleaning them up, he accidentally triggers the hologram message that R2 is carrying. It's a hologram of Princess Leia saying, "Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You are my only hope." Determined to find Obi-Wan Kenobi, R2 takes off on his own when no one is looking. And when Luke finds out, he grumbles, "This little droid is going to cause me a lot of trouble." "Oh, he excels at that, sir," adds C-3PO. And thus, the adventure begins. 9 Star Wars movies later, over 125 episodes of the animated Clone Wars, 4 seasons of Rebels, 1 season each of A Bad Bunch and Resistance, 2 additional Star Wars movies, Rogue One and Han Solo, and already 2 new TV series, The Mandalorian and The Book of Boba Fett, with more to come. We have a vast and diverse cast of characters, content, and stories. And that doesn't even include all of the extra games, comic books, created in the Star Wars world. By the time of Star Wars 9, The Rise of Skywalker, the last of the trilogies, young Princess Leia has now become General Leia Organa, more experienced in the ways of the Force and the universe, but her assessment of droids remains the same, as she reminds us to never underestimate a droid. Here is a short blurb by Josh Black, a Star Wars fan and blogger. This comes from his website, The Dork Side of the Force. "The most powerful idea conveyed by the original trilogy is that no matter how bad things get, hope is a force that always remains and can always be a force for good. In the face of the direst circumstances, they still have hope. And this never-ending hope bears results such as when we see Han saved in Return of the Jedi by his friends, and when the Empire is finally overthrown in Return of the Jedi. It's one of the most powerful lessons in all of Star Wars, the idea that no matter how dire things get, hope remains as an anchor in our life and as a catalyst for change. Hope is always there, and it drives action, which helps us to achieve our dreams in Star Wars as in real life." So this brings us to what I call the cycle of hope as a theme in the Star Wars universe. The cycle of hope has a low point where things look dire and hope is difficult to generate. The cycle has a midpoint where there is a gradual upswing and hope begins to grow. And then the cycle has a high point where the goal is achieved and hope is restored. And the cycle never ends. Even when you do save the universe, give it some time, things will get worse and someone is going to have to come along and save it all over again. If you follow the Star Wars universe long enough, you will see several of these cycles play out. The struggle between good and evil, hope and despair, is truly endless. The names and places may change, but the saga continues, an ongoing cosmic space opera of a universe finding balance, heroes and villains playing out their roles in the galaxy. Star Wars 4, A New Hope, and Star Wars 7, The Force Awakens, are two movies where the cycle of hope is on this gradual upswing, a new hope awakened. There is positive movement forward with Luke as the young Jedi in Star Wars 4, and Rey as the last hope of a Jedi in Star Wars 7. One thing that is truly amazing about Star Wars is its wide appeal. It's popular with children, adults, geeks, and critics alike, or at least most of the critics. Lucas modeled it after the Sunday morning serials from his childhood, like the Flash Gordon movies. There's humor, fast action, good guys and bad guys, and great characters that you grow to love. While the good guy, bad guy moral framework initially appears a bit cardboard-like, as the movies go on, the subtle complexities of a human dilemma become quite complex and philosophically challenging, like a Wookiee trying to win an honest game of degere on a long flight to the Outer Rim. And there are countless books that have been written on the philosophy of Star Wars, Sith, and Jedi. Throughout the movies, the heroes find themselves in situations where defeat looks inevitable. The odds are against them, as C-3PO will usually point out. And then, just when it looks like the end is near, the heroes somehow, some way, find a way to come out on top. This cycle of hope and hopelessness repeats itself over and over in the Star Wars series, and we find ourselves drawn into the story as well, wondering which character might we be, or what might we do in real life if we found ourselves in such a situation. Hope allows us to charge into the darkest of times head first, believing in the good we cannot see, hinging only on the feeling that we can emerge victorious despite insurmountable odds. Hope is never totally exhausted. Even a small amount of hope can get the cycle moving again, even when the cycle appears to have bottomed out. In Star Wars 8, The Last Jedi, there's a low point near the end of a movie, and Leia says, "We have fought to the end, but the galaxy has lost all its hope. The spark has gone out." C-3PO even gives the odds of their escape at 15,428 to 1. But then, as Luke Skywalker battles Kylo Ren one-on-one, he buys them time, which allows the resistance to escape and continue the fight for another day, leading Poe Dameron to declare, "We are the spark that will light the fire that will bring the First Order down." The closing scene in Star Wars 8 has Leia and Rey of the Millennial Falcon discussing what their next move is after such a narrow escape and a low point in their struggle. And Rey asks Leia, "How do you build a rebellion from this?" And Leia says, "We have everything we need." So this morning, here are 5 things about hope in the Star Wars series. 5 things we need to remember that we have everything we need. 1, it takes effort. 2, it's never too late. 3, don't try to go it alone. 4, you're never going to be ready. And 5, never give up. Hope shines through the darkness. So 1, it takes effort. As Han Solo told Chewbacca when the Wookiee asked him how he's supposed to fly the Millennium Falcon at a distance but not look like he's trying to keep his distance, Han shouts, "I don't know. Flies casual." Hope doesn't always come easy. In most cases, you have to try really hard to generate enough hope to keep going and make something hopeful happen. But don't make it look too hard. Fly casual. 2, it's never too late. There's a scene in The Rise of Skywalker, Star Wars 9, with Han Solo talking to his son Ben, also known as Kylo Ren, Supreme Leader of the First Order. He's trying to get Ben to come back to the Resistance, telling him that it's not too late. He can still rejoin the cause. "Your mother is gone, But what she stood for and what she fought for, that's not gone. Ben realizes that even with all the mistakes he's made, and Kylo Ren was certainly a disturbed Sith, he can still change and set things right. And he does. And as you remember, in the original trilogy, it was Darth Vader, Ben's grandfather, who turned from the dark side, returning balance to the Force when no one expected him to do it, except for Luke. Luke knew that there was still light in his father. He knew that it's never too late. Thirdly, don't try to go it alone. In a scene from Rise of Skywalker, Star Wars 9, Poe Dameron is talking to Zori Bliss on the planet of Kijimi. They were members of the same Spice Runners gang years ago, before he joined the Resistance, and now we're discussing the current state of affairs. Zori is trying to talk him into coming away with her while they can. And Poe says, "I can't walk out on this war until it's over. We sent out a call at the Battle of Crete in The Last Jedi. Nobody came. Everyone is so afraid they've given up." And Zori replies, "No, I don't believe you believe that. They win by making you think you're alone. Remember, there are more of us than them." Throughout the Star Wars series, hope is found in relationships and trusted alliances. Oftentimes, it's the strength and loyalty of relationships that bring people through circumstances that they could not have on their own. As I rewatched several of these movies preparing for this presentation, I had a hard time not getting emotionally involved. I was a mess. I've grown to love these characters and the relationships between these characters. And I think the more times I watch these movies, the worse it gets. Every time I watch Han Solo show up to help Luke and the Resistance at the Death Star, I let out a big whoop. When you have a group of people you love, you will do whatever it takes to help each other out. In Star Wars, they do it over and over again. Don't go it alone. Number four, you're never going to be ready. As Star Wars 9, The Rise of Skywalker, winds down, General Leia Organa has just died, and Poe Dameron is now in charge, and he's seated beside Leia's bedside, contemplating what should he do next. He says that he doesn't know what to do, and that he's not ready for the challenge. Lando Calrissian walks in and offers his advice from the original trilogy. And he said, "Luke, Han, Leia, none of us were ready either." And Poe asks, "So how did you do it? How did you defeat an empire with nothing?" And Lando says, "We had each other. That's how we won." So this takes us right back to point three. Don't go it alone. Do it together. And in this show, Lando says, "Then we go together." And they make their plan for the closing finale of Star Wars 9. Lando and Chewie take the Falcon to the core systems and send out a call to help for anyone who is listening to come and join the final fight. And then Poe gives his best speech ever. He says, "We have friends out there. They'll come if they know there's hope. The First Order wins by making us think we're alone. And we're not alone. Good people will fight if we lead them. Leia never gave up, and neither will we. We're going to show them we're not afraid. What our mothers and fathers fought for, We will not let die. Not today. Today, we make our last stand for the galaxy, for Leia, for everyone we've lost. Which leads to point number 5. Never give up hope. Hope shines through the darkness. C-3PO gives his own short speech, short by his standards, just before, in this show, he decides to have his memory erased by Babu Frick in order to assist the cause. C-3PO says, "If this mission fails, it was all for nothing. All we've done. All this time. And all these movies, I might ask. Don't let the dark times or negativity or the bad odds overwhelm you. Dark times and good times, hope is always there. Maintain a hopeful and positive attitude no matter what you're doing, and don't give up to despair. Hope shines through the darkness." So in conclusion, it turns out that our galaxy is not all that different from that other galaxy far, far away. We both have our galactic challenges that require hope and heroes to bring back balance to the everyday workings of our universe. May each of us find our way in this sometimes dark and perilous world. May hope shine in the darkness. May hopefulness guide our journey. And in the famous words of Star Wars lore, may the Force be with you. As we extinguish the chalice today, two final hope quotes. The first by Jyn Erso from Rogue One, when she says, "Rebellions are built on hope." And the second by General Leia Organa from The Last Jedi, "Hope is like the sun. If you only believe it when you can see it, you'll never make it through the night." I'd like to thank you for joining us for today's UU Holton Weekly Service. Like and subscribe on our YouTube channel. Practice kindness, keep your attitude positive, and look out for those having a difficult time. I want to thank Christoph, our cameraman, for filming today's content, and also Fem Carmichael, board barista on the production end. I hope you have enjoyed the Star Wars opening crawl, written especially for today's content and produced by Jedi Knight Fen aboard Barista. And we have one more short slideshow for you in case you didn't get enough. And it's the closing track from Star Wars 7, The Force Awakens. This is the Jedi Steps and Finale. Have a good rest of your day, everyone, and we'll see you next time on The Inside Take.